Bonjour à tous, bonsoir à tous, je ne sais pas quelle heure il est chez vous, mais en tout cas ça me fait très très plaisir de vous retrouver. Donc comme d'habitude, so as every time I will say hello to all the persons that are here, so the water bearer is here, bonjour, Kusum is here too. Cosmina Bellou is with us. Yossi is here too. Victoria Jacques est là. Priyanka is with us. Emma Chomao. Lani too. Yoglet. Nice to meet you, Yoglet. Bonjour. Hilary Howell is here. Luciana Moribé. Ice Cubes. Bonsoir. Lanora, bonjour. Enibokun est là. Well, I guess everybody. Jezebel, Rita Assor, Emiche, and JJ. Well, I guess we can start right now and then. Well, let me press on the correct button because this is the thing that I need to make sure. And we will start with the monument of the day. And the monument of the day, well, it's in Paris and it's Le Grand Palais. So I don't know if you had the pleasure to go in Le Grand Palais or just, well, walk next to it. But then it's really a beautiful, beautiful building. So please write me a little sentence to describe what you can see on this picture. And Rita again, thank you very much for the coffee. I don't know, it's a little character, interesting character who is offering the coffee. Merci Rita. Alors, I can see that MJ is the first one to write Le Grand Palais est vraiment un grand palais. Perfectly written. Maybe you don't need to put the accent on the A in grand, okay? Kanshan, il y a un bâtiment crème, d'accord? Beng Rekik, bonjour, you can join. So the Google Trisker, j'aime le grand palais, perfectly written. You should probably remove your E from the je and put the apostrophe, okay? So j'aime. Hilary Howell, le grand palais est un bâtiment magnifique. Perfect. Yvette, bonjour Yvette, you can participate and write a sentence to describe this picture. Ensuite, Enibokun, je vois un grand manoir. Très bien. Yossi, le palais que nous voyons sur la photo est très beau. Perfect, Yossi, as usual. Olga, bonjour, monsieur le prof. Bonjour, Olga, participez. You can participate, please. Priyanka, le palais est magnifique. Parfait, Priyanka. Sapna, il me semble un type de lycée et d'université. Peut-être, maybe. Ice Cubes, malheureusement, j'étais très occupé avec mon ami. It's the same person again. It's always the same story. The one where you did not go to Lyon quand j'étais là. Mais ça semble un grand palais et un peu classique, un peu moderne. D'accord. The water bearer looks like a very pretty old and bright government building. It's not really government. Sorry, I can't write in French myself. No problem about that. It's palais. Palais, it was before the Republic. Victoria Jacques, un bel immeuble avec une belle architecture. Très bien. Lanora, le grand palais à Paris, est beige. Lani, le grand palais est l'un des monuments parisiens les plus symboliques. Très bien. Gaspard, bonjour Gaspard, vous pouvez participer. Chrismo, j'ai vu des arbres, mais rien après là. Ok, Cosmina Bellou, un endroit qui peut-être est utilisé pour les défilés de mode. Alors, as I've been starting that, a few days ago, or maybe last week, the idea is to, if you want to ask some questions, things that I didn't have the time to answer during the lives, then you can ask your question. You send me your question to askvincent@fluent2plus.com, and I will try to compile all the questions and make a video with your questions and my answers. Okay, so if I don't have the time to answer to your questions during the live, then in that case you can still send them to this address and I will take my time, but I will try to make a video with all the questions and some answers and tips. Okay, and the question of the day is, qu'est-ce que vous prenez au petit déjeuner? En général, qu'est-ce que vous prenez au petit déjeuner? So what do you have for breakfast normally? Alors, Priyanka is the first one to answer. Je prends du pain avec du beurre et du thé. Très bien. Remember that when you conjugate prendre for the first person, je prends, it goes with DS in the end. So don't forget the S, even if we don't pronounce it, you should definitely write it. Olga, je regarde un ballet à Bogota. Très beau. Ok, d'accord, Rita, je mange bonbons. Rita mange des bonbons. So you're eating some candies. The water bearer, merci, je vous en prie. Alors, Kanchan, j'ai mangé du pain et du beurre. Très bien. Yvette Samara qui mange des fruits. C'est très bien. Victoria Jacques, du thé et des fruits. Très bien. Luciana Moribé, je prends du café au lait et un pain avec du beurre. Très bien. Gaspard, je prends un café au lait avec une tartine beurrée. Don't forget the U. The Google Trisker, le thé et des cookies. Très bien. Lanora, je mange une salade de fruits. Yossi, je prends au petit déjeuner du cottage et du yaourt avec une pomme. Très bien. Désiré, je prends une tasse de thé au lait, du pain avec de la confiture. Remember, it goes with F-I-T-U-R-E. Danubio, je mange un yaourt, du pain avec beaucoup de beurre et un café fort. Très bien. Chrismo, je fais du thé. Kusum, je mange des saucisses et un œuf. Hilary, je prends de la soupe et des suppléments vitaminiques. Très bien. You should put the supplement in the plural form and then vitaminic or then vitaminé as well in the plural form. MJ, au petit déjeuner, je prends du jus d'orange et du pain intégral. Désiré qui dit de la confiture. Mohana qui nous dit je prends du pain avec de la confiture. Gigi is telling us, je bois un café. Remember that the verb boire, when you conjugate it in the first person, je bois, you will write it B-O-I-S. You don't pronounce the final S, but still you should write it like that. Everald Clark, bonjour à tous de la Jamaïque. Je prends du pain avec des œufs. Miam, miam. Lani, je mange du pain, un pain au chocolat avec une tasse de café. Sapna, je prie un paranta avec ma famille. C'est un plat commun en Inde. Les gens prennent ce plat la plupart du temps le matin. Très bien. Cosmina Bellou, maintenant, pour le petit déjeuner, je bois un grand verre avec du lait de chèvre et je prends un café aussi. Maria Betania, je prends du café et parfois des toasts et de la gelée. Quelqu'un d'autre dont je n'arrive pas à lire le nom, je prends de la banane. Olga Ruiz, je prends le petit encoro. Qu'est-ce que c'est encoro? Je ne sais pas ce que c'est. Taina, quel est votre Instagram, Vincent? you don't want to know. The water bearer. Ou, alors attendez. Ok, you want to use Google Translate for that? So, je mange un petit déjeuner anglais le matin. Œufs, saucisses, haricots et tomates. Ok. Pork Ritter, des cigarettes Marlboro et de la Smirnoff. In the morning, it must be extremely good, especially for the voice. After that, you've got the perfect voice. Yanni, je prends un café avec du pain. Ice Cubes, aujourd'hui, j'ai pris mon café, comme d'habitude, avec des biscuits. Mais en général, j'aime faire mon petit déjeuner plus riche, avec des fromages, la marmelade, une omelette, un peu de pain, etc. Et avec un café au lait. Enibokun, ce matin, j'ai mangé du pain avec de la confiture et j'ai bu un jus d'orange. Jenny Prenny nous dit, j'ai mangé des gaufres. Et Rita S. nous dit, j'ai bu du thé. So in the next exercise, we'll translate some verbs because as you probably know, I like usually to offer you some exercises to translate verbs. It's really important. In that situation, you need to keep in mind that all the verbs that you will have to find, so the French verbs, will be reflexive verbs. Okay, so there will be only reflexive verbs. Remember, the reflexive verbs are constructed with the se in the front, okay, so, and then the verb is coming. So let's have a look at the first one. And the first one, if you look carefully, it's to sit down. So how could you translate to sit down into French, keeping in mind that I want a reflexive verb for that? Merci. Alors, I can see that Yana is joining us. Bonjour et bienvenue, welcome. So we're trying to translate some verbs, and in French I'm expecting reflexive reflexive verb, so you've been joining, which is good. So we agree that it's s'asseoir. So you've got two options if you want to write it the old-fashioned way, like I did with the e after the two s, or then you can write it without it. So it's just because I've been I've been learning this verb like that when I was little, so I keep this this way of writing it. The other one without it, it's totally okay. Still, the only thing that you really need to remember is that you need to remove your e from the se and put the apostrophe. Okay, so s'asseoir was the verb that we were looking for. So let's have a look at the second one. And the second one is to stand up. So how would you translate to stand up into French, keeping in mind that I want a reflexive verb? Bonjour Deschem. Deschem, you can welcome the lesson right now. So you just need to follow the exercises. We're making some exercises. And in that case, the exercise is quite simple. I put a verb in English and try to translate this verb into French, keeping in mind that this one should be reflexive. And look at the others. I mean, they can help you. No worries about that. Alors, in that case, yes, I was looking for se lever. Alors, Mohana has been giving also the option of se tenir debout. Se lever would be the most simple one if you want, because se tenir debout can be also tricky if you want to conjugate it. So se lever, it's quite simple. Stand up, se lever. Allez, let's have a look at. One second. Sapna is asking, qu'est-ce que soulever? C'est un nom de se lever. Non, 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 non. Soulever, c'est porter. Soulever, it would be like carry something. So soulever, if you want to know the weight of an object, you will have to carry it, but to take it from the ground. So this is soulever. Hein. Se lever, it's really, in that case, the reflexive verb. So for yourself, hein. They are quite different. Alors, let's look at the number 3. Numéro 3. And the number 3 is to go to bed or to lay down. So how would you translate this one? Remember, reflexive verb. Alors, let's have a look at my suggestion. In that case, it's se coucher. It seems that everyone was going for this one. Jenny Prini has been offering s'allonger. S'allonger would be, yeah, it would be an option too, if you want. I mean, s'allonger could be possible. Se coucher, it's more like to go to bed, to lay down. But still, I mean, s'allonger would be totally possible. Both of them are well, from the first group. So let's have a look at number four. So number four is to take a shower. Remember, to take a shower, in that case, it should be also, well, a reflexive verb. So I am waiting for you. Alors, in that situation, well, it's quite simple because the simple way to do it would be to actually take a shower, une douche, as the base of your construction. So the verb would be se doucher. Se doucher, prendre une douche for the water bearer. Prendre une douche would be totally possible. Somebody was putting... se baigner, not really, because se baigner would be like to take a bath, hein, se baigner, so it's not really the take a shower concept. So se doucher, it's really to take a shower. Maria Betania, se laver, oui, se laver, it's a bit more general because it's to clean yourself, in fact, and you've got many ways to do it, you don't need to take a shower to do that. So se doucher, it's really to take a shower. Let's have a look at numéro 5. Numéro 5, eh bien, c'est to dress up. How would you translate to dress up? And don't forget that I am expecting for, well, a reflexive verb. Alors, to dress up, yes, well, from what I see, you give me the good answers. I mean, it's s'habiller, hein? Same thing, reflexive verb, s'habiller. So it means that when you will conjugate all these verbs, remember that you will have to put, well, the pronouns. So, je m'habille, tu t'habilles, il, elle s'habille, nous, nous habillons, vous, vous habillez, il, elle s'habille. Okay, so that's it for this exercise. Merci beaucoup. So let's discover the city of the day, and today I'm pretty excited because we go to Occitanie and we will discover this beautiful city called Montpellier. And of course, Montpellier, it's an important place for me because my daughter is living in Montpellier. So look at the picture and try, please, to write me a sentence to describe what you can see. Alors, Cosmina Bellou is the first one to really answer and write the sentence in French. Je vois une rue aussi propre qu'elle scintille. C'est probablement pour la photo. Victoria Jacques qui nous dit I love it there. Mais c'est sympathique. It's a nice, I think it's a nice area. I really like this part of France. It's usually people are really warm and nice. Victoria Blends qui nous dit « Oh, l'Occitanie !» Eh oui, c'est magnifique. Roupa dit « Magnifique !» Olga Ruiz, « Belle et magnifique !» Alors, je ne sais pas ce que c'est, viol. Ville. Yasmine nous dit « La ville est éclairée » et c'est très bien écrit. Deschem, « It looks beautiful », très beau. Luciana Moribé, je vois deux bâtiments et une place. Oui, Hilary, c'est une belle ville. Rupa, grande et beaucoup d'illumination. Yasmine qui rajoute, et grande. Priyanka, Montpellier est la plus grande ville de France. Non, ça n'est pas la plus grande ville de France. Monisha, je peux voir les lumières, une vue du soir. Yossi, sur la photo, on peut voir un grand édifice, probablement un centre commercial. Il se trouve sur une immense place. MJ, j'espère aller dans ces endroits un jour, c'est magnifique. Victoria Jacques, une belle ville avec des lumières qui brillent la nuit. Yenitsomo, très lumineux et beau. Jenny, la rue est très propre, c'est une belle ville. Gaspard, je vois une dans la nuit avec des bâtiments allumés. Peut-être une place, hein, vous avez oublié place. Ask Jeannette se déguiser. You should refresh your page, Ask Jeannette, because it seems that we're not really synchronized. Sapna, la lumière partout dans cette place, c'est une vue de nuit. Emma Chomao, je peux voir la fille de Vincent marcher au loin. Oui, mais attention avec le couvre-feu, il faut pas. M&M 19, une belle ville, surtout la nuit. Oui, et la vieille ville, the old city of Montpellier, it's really, really nice. Yana, une très jolie ville d'un bâtiment ancien, grand passage et propre. Jean, je vois un bâtiment trop beau et quelque chose comme une place publique. Très bien, Jean. The Waterbearer, je vois une place de la ville avec des bâtiments merveilleusement luxueux. Très bien. Bickert, bonjour Bickert. Norman Peters, bonjour aussi. Elisa, quelle belle ville. Lanora, il y a de beaux bâtiments. Bridget Nafula, oui, très magnifique. Mohana Devi, ça a l'air génial. Je voudrais la visiter un jour. Eh ben oui. You should definitely go and visit all this area in the south of France. You can go to the other, I mean, the east part of the south, but the west part of the south is really interesting too. Priyanka, how do we write, sorry, the third largest city of France. La troisième ville de France. Save the best. C'est une très belle ville et des super bâtiments. J'espère la visiter un jour. Yasmine, et je vois le couvre-feu. Oui. Ah, c'est ça, hein, c'est ça, 21h. Kyler, bonjour Kyler. Arthur, bonjour Arthur. Très bien. Lani, c'est une très belle ville de France sur la Méditerranée. Oui, et juste à côté de la mer. Et c'est ça qui est formidable. Alors, as you might know, we've been starting that, and I've got the pleasure to offer you 10 audiobooks. if you want and if you need them. So the way to proceed will be extremely simple. First, you will have to go to audible.com. Remember that in that case, it must be only the US site. So not any local or well, not the British site, for instance, and not the other versions. It must be the US site. So probably you can lock it and you can force it to go to the US site. Then the second thing will be, basically I will give you 10 codes. You just need to grab one and you enter that and you can have the book for free. In exchange, it would be nice, a little bit like the likes when we have the lives on YouTube. I would like you to write me a little review and give me a grade for the book, so it will be more visible for the others. So the concept is simple, as I say all the time: first arrived, first serve. So you will have to get your code. I will give you the codes. And after that, you just pick one, go there, and it will be free for you. So these are the first five codes. And as you can see, it's one more time the indicative present. So it will be the conjugation, but it's the second part of it. So we've been having the first one, and now it's the second part of it. So it means that it will be the verbs, the most used verbs, but from 101 to 100, 200. So by grabbing one of these codes, you will be able to get it for free. And this is the second page of the code, so five more codes. Voilà, voilà, voilà. Allez, we can continue. So now it's, what does she think about? And it's actually quite simple. I mean, look, you know that I like to put some pictures. The picture is right there, and the question is simple: à quoi pense-t-elle? Please write me one sentence. Just imagine, à quoi pense-t-elle? Allez-y. Alors, Michelle Washington, who is telling us, I am trying to relearn French again. Well, it's a good thing. Don't worry, you can make it. So, welcome to the lessons. You just need to follow the exercises. And in that case, you just have a picture here and you try to think, what could she think about? So write a sentence, and after that, I will read the sentences and correct them if needed. Alors, Netara is telling us, elle a l'air très chic. Okay, so it's a description in that case. M&M19, elle pense à quitter son travail. Okay, Yossi is asking, okay, Yossi, don't worry, I will make a step-by-step explanations if you don't manage to make it, no problem. Rupa, elle pense à sa fille. Daria qui nous a rejoint, elle ne comprend pas les gens qui ne peuvent pas mettre un like, ça n'est pas raisonnable, c'est vrai. Merci Daria. Lanora, j'ai mal à la tête, d'accord. Hillary, elle pense à son travail. MJ, elle pense à l'amour de sa vie. Jean, elle pense aux leçons qu'elle devait faire hier et qu'elle n'a pas encore faites, d'accord. Ice Cubes, elle pense à manger quelque chose. C'est possible que vous avez faim. Monisha, elle pense quand le Covid partira. Eh oui, Yana, elle pense à notre professeur. Bah, c'est gentil, j'espère qu'elle pense à la grammaire ou à la conjugaison. Sapna, elle a l'air fatiguée. Elle a l'intention de faire une sieste après donner une pause au photographe, d'accord, après avoir posé. Bickert, elle ne pense pas pourquoi les choses sont-elles allées bien, d'accord. Ou elle pense que... Ah, elle se demande pourquoi les choses ne sont pas allées aussi bien. Elle pense qu'elle veut aller à la maison. Et Machomao, elle pense que cette odeur, qu'est-ce que ça veut dire? Une odeur, vous voulez dire? Priyanka, je pense qu'elle va au supermarché. Avec qui demain, d'accord? The Waterbearer, certains disent que la vie souffre, mais la souffrance est un beau jeu. Il ne vous récompense pas avec ce que vous méritez, d'accord? Jenny, elle médite. Très bien. Yasmine, elle pense que la vie était belle sans le masque. C'est vrai. Lani, elle pense, que dois-je faire pour améliorer mon français? Beaucoup de choses, hein. On sait que c'est difficile. Olga, elle pense à son futur. Yossi, elle pense à sa famille et comment se débrouiller pendant la pandémie. Bridget, elle pense à la beauté. Très bien. Gaspard, elle est inquiète. I just called, elle est triste. Elle vient de perdre quelqu'un de cher. Oh, c'est triste. Mohana, je pense qu'elle réfléchit profondément à la façon de s'échapper du corona et de survivre au reste de la vie. Très bien écrit, Mohana. Deschen, elle pense qu'elle rêve. Ça, c'est sympa. Sanjana, elle est triste. Non, pourquoi? Cosmina Bellou, elle ne pense à rien. Elle est pétrifiée parce que derrière, il y a un gangster avec une arme dans son dos. C'est vrai qu'elle a l'air tendue. Maria Bethania, elle pense quelque chose de mauvais parce qu'elle porte une veste noire comme les personnages de films de suspense. Ça, c'est intéressant. Norman Peters, elle pense à la fin de la pandémie. Oui. Kirill, elle pense à un coup d'échec. Ah, peut-être qu'elle joue aux échecs. Arège, elle pense à un problème qui est grand. Très bien. Evelyne, oh, merci Evelyne. Thank you very much. If you like me as a teacher, well, I like you as a student. Kyler, elle pense à trop de devoirs. What do you want to say with that, Kyler? Not sure I understand. Les devoirs, homework, or devoir, something that you have to do? I'm not sure I got it. Vous le savez. Vous savez qu'effectivement, maintenant, mon petit plaisir personnel, quand nous faisons des lives comme ça, c'est d'avoir au minimum, 100 likes. Vous êtes 150. So you are actually more than 150 persons and I've got only 50 four likes, come on, s'il vous plaît, like me, please. Allez, let's continue with the conjugaison. So, we'll do some conjugation. In that case, it will be only indicatif présent. D'accord? So, we'll focus on this tense that is extremely, extremely useful. The verb is venir. Venir is to come, and I am expecting you. So, we will not cover all these things, but only indicatif présent in that case. Could you please give me je, tu, il, and elle for venir? Alors, so we agree that venir, when it comes to the singular form, so je, tu, il, and elle, it's not really, really tricky, so you will pronounce them exactly the same way. Je viens, with the S, tu viens, with the S, il, elle, vient, with the T. So remember, final S won't be pronounced and final T won't be pronounced. So this is the same form. So je viens, tu viens, il vient, elle vient. Très bien. Could you give me please nous, vous, il and elle? Alors, let's have a look, because in that case, well, the difficulty is because, as you can see, for nous and vous, you will have one root, one stem, that will be V-E-N. So, nous venons, vous venez. Remember, O-N-S for nous, it's the classic ending. EZ for vous, it's the classic ending too. So, nous venons, vous venez. But then the difficulty is to remember that for il and elle, as you can see on your screen, you will have to double the N. And it means that it will impact the sound of your E that is just before. So, you will pronounce it vienne. Il vienne. Elles viennent. Okay, so one more time. Nous venons, vous venez, ils viennent, elles viennent. And this is the verb venir, and definitely you should know it by heart. So try to push yourself, try to learn it by heart, because, I mean, these verbs are extremely, extremely useful and extremely important, and you need to really learn them by heart. Okay? Thank you. Okay, so let's do the next exercise. There is this person, Ryder Craigie, who seems to be extremely upset. I don't know what's happening with you, Ryder Craigie. Just take the time to breathe. Life is good. Allez, the next one is how would you translate? So remember, we've been covering already the verbs. So we've been doing the reflexive verbs for the translation. And now, well, we'll go to... Let's have a look. Sentences. Can you please translate these sentences? Alors, I can see that you start to give me your suggestions. So, in that case, obviously the verb will be aller. So, elle va. And then after that, the question is, what is the bakery? So, the first translation will be la boulangerie. So, we'll put the preposition à la boulangerie. Ouria is offering la pâtisserie. Well, pâtisserie, and it's true that you can see in most of the cases, boulangerie, pâtisserie, because it can be in the same place. There you can buy your bread and your pastries. But if it's really the translation of bakery, it will be la boulangerie. D'accord? So it's not really wrong, but still, you should translate it with boulangerie. Elle va à la boulangerie. Remember, boulangerie, it's with A, hein? L-A-N-G-E-R-I-E. So the second one is, she doesn't take her car. So how could you translate this sentence? She doesn't take her car into French. Go for it. Alors, I can see that there are some comments first. Lipstick Princess, good morning from America. Well, welcome to the lesson. And then Nobi saying, I hate French, it's hard, very hard. What is your mother tongue, Nob? Because it depends, your mother tongue, if you're talking another or already talking another foreign language, I don't really know. It's a complex question, but give me more information, Nob, if you want to discuss about that. Because I'm pretty sure that, I mean, if you really try, you can learn French. I mean, look at these persons. I mean, they are extremely gifted and they're writing some beautiful sentences. So let's have a look here. She doesn't take her car. So obviously we will use the verb prendre. D'accord? So prendre, remember when you conjugate it in the third person of the singular, in that case you will write it P-R-E-N-D. Okay? So P-R-E-N-D. And then we will put the negative form, obviously. So we'll start with the ne, we put our verb, and after that we put pas, be after the verb. Elle ne prend pas. And the tricky thing, but apparently you didn't make any mistake there. So you remember that in French we will define the possessive, so the gender of the possessive, according to the word it is connected to. In that case, voiture is a feminine noun. So it means that you will have to take sa because it's the feminine form and it is related to voiture. Okay, Nob is saying that it's English and Hindi. So Nob, the thing is that if you think about that, in that case, English and French, I mean, share like thousands of words. So you have already a lot of words in common. But after that, of course, for the grammar, it can be tricky. But it's not impossible. Allez, let's have a look at number 3. Number 3, it's she likes to play sports. She likes to play sports. Please translate these or this sentence into French. Thank you. Alors, I can see that you are writing, well, in most of the cases, you are putting the same thing as I was writing. So, elle aime, so we agree that in that case, it's the verb aimer. Elle aime, the second verb should be in the infinitive. And normally, the expression is faire, faire du sport. So, elle aime faire du sport. We won't really use jouer in that case because in French we don't use jouer when we talk about sports. So, we will use faire, and in most of the cases we will go for the singular form. Faire du sport. Faire des sports, I mean, technically and grammatically it's possible, but this is not really what we would say or what we would write. So, faire du sport, it's really the expression that we would use. Kathleen is joining us. Bonjour, Kathleen, you can participate to the lesson. Let's have a look at the fourth sentence that you have to translate, and it is, she is very generous. She's very generous. How could you translate that into French? Alors, she is very generous. In that case, if you translate directly, because this is the concept, here the concept is to try to translate directly. So, obviously, we will go with elle, because it's the feminine form, so singular feminine, elle. After that, the verb être, elle est, très, that would be this adverb, that is the equivalent of very. And then, well, direct translation of generous is généreuse. Remember, it will be généreux for the masculine, but in that case, we will put the feminine form because the subject is feminine, so généreuse. Okay, elle est très généreuse. Allez, let's have a look at the last one. So number 5, and number 5 is she can't come. She can't come. How can you translate that into French? Alors, in that case, let's have a look at, well, the first verb, can, it's pouvoir. Remember, it's a tricky one, because when you start to conjugate it, especially for the three first persons, you will have to change the root, and it will be je peux, P-E-U-X, tu peux, P-E-U-X, and then il, elle peut, P-E-U-T. You pronounce them the same way, but still, you need to write it differently. So we will put the negative form before and after this verb. So elle ne peut pas. And then the second verb, venir, would be, of course, in the infinitive form, because it's the second verb after pouvoir that is conjugated. Elle ne peut pas venir. Merci beaucoup. So let's try to change the type of exercise. And now it's the three verbs of the day. And as you know, if you participate regularly to the lessons, I give you a picture. And in that case, you can see the picture and try to find me three verbs from this picture. Please write the verbs in the infinitive form. Merci beaucoup. Alors, the doudou man is the first one with trouver. Yossi, manger, parler, goûter. Yana, cuisiner, manger, probablement, you forgot the N, ajouter. Adi, Edi, déjeuner, be careful you write it with the E and not O. Déjeuner, manger, and then sourire. Hilary, manger, faire, oui, ou cuisiner. Alors ensuite, it's going really fast now, so I need to go slowly. Rania, manger, ok. Ouria, manger, regarder. Rania, parler. Yana, cuisiner, manger, ajouter. Très bien. Renato, manger, regarder et préparer. Très bien. Koala Star Studio, parler, cuisiner, manger. Parfait. Rania encore. Alors attendez, it's going too fast for me. I need to scroll. Alors attendez, c'était... Oui, Rania, regarder. Jean, regarder, cuisiner, attendre. Très bien. Rupa, garçon, une fille. Yep, I was asking for verbs. Emma Chomao, sourire, manger, regarder. Bickert, préparer, s'amuser, attendre. Très bien. Ensuite, Sapna, manger, voir, penser. Mohana, regarder. You forgot the R, Mohana. Lever, penser. Save the best. Manger, préparer, rire. Très bien. Gaspard, aimer, chanter. Who is singing? Madagé. Pourquoi pas? Omar, cuisiner, regarder, déguster. And then I will take one more. Monisha, cuisiner. Be careful, Monisha. So your verbs, in fact, they're not reflexive. Okay? So it should be cuisiner, manger, and then sourire. So you don't put any reflexive form here because these verbs are not reflexive at all. D'accord? « So as you know, conjugation is really important. So that's the reason why we will cover a few tenses that normally you should master when you are, well, between beginner and intermediate. So it means that we've been covering already the present of venir. And now we want to have a look at the passé composé tense. And, well, I thought it might be interesting to take another verb that is like venir. In fact, it's not venir, it's devenir. Devenir, it's to become. But clearly, you will conjugate devenir like you conjugate venir. Okay, so it's another way to somehow work on the same verb, but gaining a new verb for the same price. Allez, on y va. So we will... No, it's not this one. It's passé composé. Passé composé. Je, tu, il, elle, please. Alors, let's have a look at the form. So, remember that passé composé is a compound tense. It means that it will use what we call a helping verb. And there are two options, in fact. The first one is avoir, to have, that most of the verbs will use. The second one is être. And être, we've got, well, few verbs, but still, devenir, venir are belonging to this group. So it means that you will have to use être. So look at your form. You take être and you put être in the present form. Je suis. Then, because it's a compound tense, we need to put the second part. The second part is what we call the participe passé form, the past participle form of devenir. And the past participle form of devenir is devenu, as you can see on your screen. So, je suis devenu. And the rule is quite simple in French. When you start to use être as a helping verb, you will put at the end of your past participle devenu the mark of the feminine, like here, if it's feminine, the mark of the plural, s, if it's plural, the mark of the feminine plural, es, if it's feminine plural, I'm talking about the subject. So, je suis devenu, tu est devenu. Oops, look. It's good to do that. Voilà, in real time. It's the same here. Tu es devenu, and then il, elle. Voilà. Il, elle est devenu. So this is the verb être, remember, plus the participe passé. Je suis devenu. Tu est devenu, il est devenu, elle est devenu. D'accord? Look at now, please. Alors, let's try to click now and to make sure that it can work. Voilà. Could you please give me nous, vous, il, and elle for the plural form? Merci. Thank you. Alors, we continue with the well persons, nous, vous, il, and elle. So it means that it will be exactly the same thing as we had previously. We will use our helping verb être, so in the present, nous sommes. Then we put the past participle, le participe passé, devenu. So in that situation, you can see that at the end I've been putting the S because it's the plural form, but always the option of the feminine, e. Vous êtes devenu, same thing here, plural with the option of the e. Ils sont devenus, elles sont devenues. So one more time, je suis devenu, tu es devenu, il est devenu, elle est devenue, nous sommes devenus, vous êtes devenus, ils sont devenus, elles sont devenues. Eh bien, voilà, that's it for the passé composé of the verb devenir. Let's not forget that we've got right now 93 likes, but still there are 193 persons, so please like. I would like to have at least 100. Be nice with me, 100 likes, it's the minimum, it is the minimum. Allez, merci beaucoup, nous continuons, we can continue. And so the numbers of the day, as you probably know, if you are a regular, Victoria Jacques, I hope I don't stress you too much with the with the siren. Well, I know, but it's the only thing, the only sound I found for that. So the numbers of the day, I will read some numbers and you will have to write them, okay? I will read them two times and it should be enough. I will try to read them not too fast, so it's simple for everybody, okay? So we'll start with the first one. So you need to give me one little second and I am ready. On y va. Allez, let's go for it. First number. 78. 78. Alors, so far so good. It seems that Yossi was a bit too generous because I saw 79 for Yossi, but maybe you didn't hear quite well, or maybe I was not too clear in the way I pronounced it. Attention, Rupa, be careful, Rupa, because it's not 78 like that, but it's you wrote it 618. Jean C. Bueno is saying, en Suisse, c'est mieux. Yeah, I know. Each time I've got to interact with the Swiss people, just for the pleasure, I give my 78. And you can hear a little silence on their side. And they're just like, aha, 78. And I say, yeah, yeah. So, but French people use 78, okay? So, this was 78. Let's have a look at the next one. So, number two, I hope you're ready. So, of course, it will be a bit more difficult because now we'll have three digits, as you can see. 325. Go for it. Alors, from what I see right now, everything seems to be clear. Be careful, Michelle Washington, you were not generous enough. Only one little number in the end. So it was not 324, but it's 325. But it was really, really close. So it was good. So 325 in that case, hein, 325. If I really pronounce it, I mean, quite fast, it will be 325. Okay, so let's have a look at the number 3 now. Number 3, so as you can see, will go in the 1000 family. So we've got 4 digits. Attention, attention. 7459. 7459. Well, from what I see, everything seems to be extremely clear. So because it's correct, I don't see any mistakes yet. No, everybody is correct. Donc félicitations, bravo, bravo. So in that case, yes, 7000 first, and then 400, and finally 59. 7459. And if I say it fast, it's 7459. Allez, let's look at the next one. So this is number 4. Of course, it's getting more and more difficult. Get ready. 12853. 12853. Alors, Yvette, I think you're not synchronized with us, so that's the reason why it's the same for Blaine. Be careful, and maybe you want to refresh your page so that you can be synchronized with us. So in that case, it was 12000, so 853. I am looking at your answers right now, and it seems that, I mean, the one who are synchronized, it's actually quite good. Alors, Lena Maki is telling me to shut up. Well, if I shut up in that case, Lena Maki, there is no stream. It's a strange concept. People can be really interesting. Alors, 12853. 3. I am on Zoom. Well, in that case, you're not supposed to be here, Lena. I hope you do fine, Lena. Allez, let's continue with the next exercise. Alors, I started to speak about the new series and remember that I will make a video soon on it. The idea is to help you to pronounce perfectly French, so you record yourself with your phone while pronouncing the phrase that I will give you. And it's a new phrase now. So you will send me your video or your audio file to the following address, and it's pronounced at Fluent2Plus. And after that, I will make a video with all the clips and I will give you some tips and corrections if needed for your pronunciation. So the sentence of the week is this one. Je voudrais pouvoir parler français couramment. Je voudrais pouvoir parler français couramment. So don't be shy, participate. I think we can have fun together. And I will be pleased to help you because it's a bit limited. I mean, the interaction that we have here during the live, I cannot really correct your pronunciation. So this is one way to help you to have a perfect pronunciation in French. Allez, nous continuons avec l'exercice suivant. So the next exercise is what does she say? Just imagine, que dit-elle? Que dit-elle? Write me one sentence and I will correct your sentence if necessary. Merci. Alors, je regarde, Fahad is the first one to say that she's saying coucou ma chérie. Be careful, chérie, you will write it C-H-E-R-I-E. Adi dit que c'est mignon. C'est vrai. Sanja, coucou. Ok. Alexander Diaz, quel bébé heureux. Hilary, elle dit bonjour. Stardust, bonjour mon petit soleil. This is so beautiful. Yasmine, tu es magnifique. Deschen, elle dit qu'elle est contente. With the put the E at the end of content, okay, because it's the feminine. Yana, mon amour, mon cœur, mon bébé. Rupa, souris, mon enfant. Remember, enfant, un enfant, so it should be mon enfant. Fahad, tu es ma vie. Luciana Moribé, tu seras, A.S., très heureuse. Renato, mon petit bébé. Yossi, elle demande, te plaît? Ça te plaît? The Water Bearer, nous ne pouvons pas forcer les gens à être gentils en disant d'abord s'il vous plaît. Ok. Is it related to the question, to the picture, the water bearer? I'm not following you there. Lanora, elle dit je t'aime. Koala Star, elle dit je t'aime. MJ, bonjour à mon amour. Emma, elle dit qu'elle a faim. Oui, c'est possible. Jenny, elle dit tu es amusant. D'accord. Sanjana, ma belle-fille. Ensuite, Victoria Jacques, elle dit, s'il te plaît, dépose-moi. je suis malade. Mohana, je pense avoir dit à son bébé que tu es mon monde. Kumun, je vais le lancer. Chut. Maria Bethania, mon enfant, tu es très précieux, avant tout dans ma vie. Très bien. Berilla 71, elle dit au garçon qu'il est devenu très grand. Tu es totalement mignon. Bridget, elle dit qu'elle l'aime. Très bien. Jean, elle... Alors attendez, je t'aime ma fille. Je suis très heureuse avec toi. Hein, Jean, instead of beaucoup, use the other, I mean the adverb très, that we can use. Très, remember to enhance the adjective that is coming after. Très bon, très beau, très heureux, très chaud, etc. Omar, tu ne t'imagines pas combien je t'aime. Kirill, j'aime mon enfant. Sapna, oh mon bébé, vous êtes mon monde, vous êtes très précieux pour moi. Olga Ruiz, je t'aime mon amour. Lani, oh quelle chance d'avoir une fille comme moi. Mon rayon de soleil qui éclaire ma vie. Deschaine, maman chérie, Mohana Devi, je pense qu'elle dit à son bébé que tu es mon monde. Alors, dans cet exercice, in this exercise, it will be really simple. In fact, you need to find the opposite of the adjectives that I will give you. So we'll start with the first one. And you can see that in that case, we're using... So I will give you the masculine and the feminine. I am expecting you to give me too the masculine and the feminine. So give me the opposite of bon and bonne. Remember, it's good. Bon and bonne, what is the opposite in French? And give me the masculine and the feminine. Thank you very much. Alors, let's have a look at the opposite. And the opposite, be careful, because quite many persons tend to mix the A right after the M with O. Remember that it's really A. And when you combine A and U together, I mean these two vowels, you will get the sound O. So the opposite is mauvais, the masculine form, and the feminine form, mauvaise. Okay, so masculine final S not pronounced, so mauvais. Feminine form, you will just by adding this E pronounce the Z in the end. Mauvaise. Okay, so bon, bonne, and the opposite will be mauvais, mauvaise. Let's have a look at the number two. Look at this adjective, well, these adjectives, because you've got the masculine and the feminine. So, chaud, chaude, okay? Chaud, chaude, and it's hot, so, or warm. How would you put the opposite of chaud and chaude? What could it be in French? Thank you. I can see that you are extremely precise, and it is good because clearly everyone is giving the correct answer. So masculine form will be froid, remember, final day not pronounced, froid, and then feminine form, because you add this you will pronounce the d in the end. So masculine form froid, feminine form froide. Froid, froide. So one more time. Chaud, chaude, froid, and then froide. Let's have a look at number three. So number three, look. Two adjectives, masculine, o. Remember, H is not pronounced, so o, and final T either. O, this is the masculine. Feminine form, haute. One more time. O, haute. Could you give me, please, the opposite of these two adjectives, so masculine and feminine? Alors, we do agree that the masculine form is ba. You write it B-A-S. So masculine form ba, and the feminine form, you double the S, so you will get bas. You really hear the S that is quite strong in that case. So ba, masculine, basse, feminine form. One more time. O, haute, bas, basse. Okay? So let's have a look at the next one. And the next one, this is number four, and it is facile. So as you see, in that situation, well, we've got only one form that will be for the masculine and for the feminine, for the good reason that the basic form, that is the masculine form, is already ending with e in the end, and you don't add another e when there is no accent or anything else like that. So this form will stand for the two forms, so it means that masculine and feminine will share this form. What is the opposite, please? Alors, I can see that it's quite simple for you. It's facile to find it. Remember that we've got two F, so difficile. Same thing here. It will stand for the masculine and for the feminine. So, facile, and the opposite is difficile. Let's have a look at number five. And number five, same thing here, one adjective that will cover the masculine and the feminine because it's ending already with e in the masculine form. Possible. What is the opposite of possible? Alors, we agree that in that case, to get the opposite, in that case, we need to put this prefix, un, im. So, it's a nasal, so it's un, impossible. You don't hear any M, you don't hear, you just hear the sound of the nasal. So, one more time, it goes into your nose. So, impossible. Okay, so possible, and then the opposite is impossible. Allez, let's have a look at the next one. And the next one is, what does she do? So try to find me or to write me a sentence to tell me what is she doing. Que fait-elle? Just one sentence, take 1 minute to write it. Merci. Alors, Adi Eddy is the first one and is writing, elle lave des pommes. Remember to put the plural form at the end of your pomme with a S. Hilary, elle vend des légumes. Samuel, elle lave les pommes. Bikert, elle vend des tomates dans le marché. Oui, vous pouvez dire sur le marché aussi. Emma Chomao, elle vend des tomates. M&M19, elle vend des pommes au marché. Stardust, elle essaye de vendre ses fruits. Très bien. Renato, elle regarde quelque chose en prenant des fruits. Très bien écrit. Kyler, elle travaille au supermarché. Yossi, elle lave des tomates. Jenny, elle vend des tomates. Tarine, speak English. Well, I am speaking English, Tarine. But I need to speak a bit of French because it's a French lesson. Let's agree on that. But in most of the cases, I am explaining the things in English, Tarine. Alexander Diaz, elle nettoie les tomates. Yasmine, elle vend des tomates au marché. À virage, elle regarde le garçon. Okay. Remember, you don't put any preposition with regarder. Regarder direct, le garçon. Okay. Yana, elle fait une demande. Okay. Monisha, elle vend des légumes. Samuel David Cohen. Okay, those are really clearly apples. Oh, let's not discuss about that, Samuel. It's quite okay. As long as the grammar is good for me, I am a happy man. Ensuite, Tarine, elle vend. Lanora, elle vend des fruits. Remember, Lanora, when you conjugate elle vend, it should be without the S in the end. Lovina, elle vend des tomates. Be careful, you need to conjugate your verb and it should be elle vend, V-E-N-D. Rupa, elle achète des tomates. Okay. The water bearer, yeah, but you should try to write in French because it's difficult after that. Sapna, elle vend des tomates. D'accord. Save the best, elle lave les tomates. Ouria, elle vend des légumes sur le marché. Berilla, elle écoute l'esprit des tomates. Ça, c'est parfait. C'est parfait. Elle écoute l'esprit des tomates. Oh, j'adore cette chose. So, as you know, first of all, I would like more clicks on the like, please, because you are almost 200 now. So, I mean, I could have just a little bit more, just a little bit more. It would be nice. And then, we've been covering already the present tense. We've been covering the passé composé, remember? So it makes sense that we should somehow have a look at the futur simple. Same concept as we had previously. So we saw first venir, that was to come. We saw then devenir, to become, that is conjugated in the same manner. And now we'll see another one that is related to this venir verb, and it's revenir. Revenir, it's to come back or to come again. Remember this prefix re, that does express the repetition. Revenir. D'accord? So it means that when we will conjugate this verb, in fact, it will be almost the same for the others. I'm talking about venir and I'm talking about devenir. Okay? It is a bit tricky because now we are talking about the futur simple. And futur simple for venir, be careful. The root is changing. Try, give me je, give me tu, give me il and elle. Merci beaucoup. Alors, let's have a look at your versions, and then I will give you mine. Look, so venir, hein, because this is our root, is becoming viendre, hein, for the root of futur simple, and we will see later that it will be the same for conditionnel présent. But in that case, for the futur simple, so it means that revenir will become reviendre. Okay, and after that, you will add your endings of the futur simple. For je, it will be AI. So, je reviendrai. Je reviendrai. For tu, it will be AS. Tu reviendras. For il, elle, it will be A. Il, elle reviendra. Je reviendrai. Tu reviendras, il reviendra, elle reviendra. So give me please nous, vous, il, and elle for the futur simple of revenir. Alors, in fact, the root is still the same, so it doesn't change, it's still reviendre. But then the ending will be ONS for nous, the usual, nous reviendrons. EZ for vous, vous reviendrez. And finally, ONT for il, elle, ils reviendront, elles reviendront. Remember that it's really ONT for il and elle. Hein? Don't forget that because it can be a classic mistake. So, nous reviendrons, vous reviendrez, ils reviendront, elles reviendront. So as you know, there are things that we never miss during these lessons. The first thing is the conjugation, because it's extremely important to systematically do this conjugation. And the second thing that normally we don't miss, it's the dictation of the day. So we are going to do a dictation for sentences, if I remember correctly, because I've been preparing that in the morning. So four sentences, and I read them two times and you write them. D'accord? J'espère que vous êtes prêts. I hope you're ready because we are starting. Allez, on y va. The first one. Just one second. I need to make sure, voilà. Okay, I will read it two times. Je vais regarder ce film avec elle. Je vais regarder ce film avec elle. Allez, try to write the sentence I just read. Alors, in that sentence, I wanted, of course, to use this near future. Remember, it's the verb aller that we conjugate in the present. Je vais, V-A-I-S. And then I put my infinitive form, regarder. Je vais regarder. Then, ce film. So, ce, it's the demonstrative, and we'll put here the masculine, because film is masculine. Avec, and then we finish with elle. Je vais regarder ce film avec elle. Okay, so let's have a look at the next one. J'ai beaucoup de force aujourd'hui. J'ai beaucoup de force aujourd'hui. And it's true, I don't know who mentioned that, but I had this déjà vu. It's Kusum. Kusum just mentioned the fact that, but these sentences are from the last course, and it's true. I just realized that I didn't change them, strangely, because I was supposed to make them, so I'm sorry for that. It does happen. I'm just a man. Kusum, oui! They are from last lesson. Yeah, I was supposed to. I've been refreshing everything, but not these sentences. So in that case, but still you make the same mistake, because I remember that from the last time. Remember that the expression in French is avoir des forces. Avoir des forces. So it means that if you start to introduce the beaucoup, then in that case you will continue with the force. You can put the force in the plural form. J'ai beaucoup de force aujourd'hui. You could keep that if you want in the singular form, as most of you have been writing that. But it's also possible to put that in the plural form because the expression is avoir des forces. J'ai beaucoup de, still force can be in the plural form. But yeah, I'm sorry. I am so sorry for these four sentences. So we'll stop right there for this exercise and we'll go to the next one. Voilà, I am sorry, but again, I am just a man, and this is the only thing, but there is always one little mistake per life. It's always like that. In that case, it was just these sentences that I was supposed, of course, to change, but then I forgot that. Sorry about that. So let's continue with the conjugaison, and then it's the futur proche. Look at that, futur proche. Remember, futur proche, it's the verb aller conjugated in the present form with the infinitive. So it should be extremely, extremely simple. Let's agree on that. The verb is devenir, d'accord? Devenir is to become, we saw that. Could you please give me devenir in the futur proche for je, tu, il, and elle? Allez, go for it. Alors, je regarde. I'm looking at your forms, and from what I see, well, it's extremely good. So we agree one more time that we will have to use the verb aller. So the verb aller, we will conjugate it in the present form. So je vais, tu vas, il, elle va. And then you just need to put your infinitive right after. Je vais devenir, tu vas devenir, il, elle va devenir. So it's this concept of going to, in English, I am going to become, even if it sounds a bit heavy in English. In French, it's quite common to use this form, especially if you really want to make a slight difference between the real future that clearly carries some uncertainty because it's not for sure. With this one, because you are constructing that with the present structure, it makes it more certain. Je vais devenir, if you say that, or then if you say the real future, je deviendrai, I still have the feeling that je vais devenir is more certain. This is when you realize that, in fact, when we talk about the grammar, it's not really the grammar, it's what happens in your head, the perception that you will get with these structures. So, je vais devenir, tu vas devenir, il, elle va devenir. Could you please give me nous, vous, il, and elle for the plural, devenir futur proche. Alors, from what I see, it seems to be extremely clear for everybody, so we agree that it's the same concept, so we will just have to conjugate aller for the other person, so nous allons, and then you put your infinitive, devenir, vous allez devenir, ils vont devenir, elles vont devenir. So one more time, je vais devenir, tu vas devenir, il, elle va devenir, nous allons devenir, vous allez devenir, ils, elles vont devenir. Alors, les choses sérieuses arrivent. So we're getting serious now. Just one second, I'm typing on my thing. So remember that, please, don't, my thing just fell. Don't start right now, please. Just one second. Okay, I got it. So don't start right now, please, because probably there are some new persons. So, there is a possibility to win an access to my platform, French for Me, so for the value of $75. So, please, and let's do that, I mean, so that everyone can really benefit from it. So, the persons who already won the access, please don't play, because I think it's it would be nicer for the others. So only the persons who did not yet win the access can participate. I think it's just nice for everybody. So, of course, I will repeat that so that everyone understand. I am writing on my paper here, because I lost my notebook, I don't know where it is. So I've got a paper. I've been writing a number. The number is from 1 to 100. D'accord? Then I will give you the time to make a first round. First round, and you just give me one option, one suggestion, you write it. Okay? And then after that, the person will win. If it works from the first round, it's okay. Then we can make a second round and a third round. And we'll see. We'll see. But normally we always succeed. So the person will have a selection of courses on the platform. And I will give you the access right after. So I hope everything is clear. I've been putting my number, so you can start now. Thank you. C'était rapide, c'était très très rapide. Alors, attendez, attendez, regardons qui a gagné. Eh bien, c'est Ouria. Ouria, est-ce que vous êtes toujours avec nous, Ouria? Ouria, si vous êtes là, félicitations. Ouria avait trouvé le nombre, et le nombre, c'était 59. 59, c'était mon nombre. J'ai vu que Ouria, en tout cas, l'avait proposé en premier. Ouria, êtes-vous avec nous? Si vous êtes là, eh bien, félicitations. Et puis, peut-être que ce serait l'occasion pour tout le monde de dire bravo à Ouria. Bravo! Alors, je commençais à mettre la fin, mais non. Ouria, let me take the time to explain to you. So basically, I guess that probably you remember how it goes. You will go to the platform frenchforme.net. You just register and then you send me a message through the platform. You will see that there is in the menu, there is a possibility to contact us, okay? And so you send me a message, you tell me that you're the lucky one, and I will give you the access to the courses that you just won. And I am really, really happy for you, Ouria. So the good news for the others, it's just like there is one less person to compete with, and you will win. I just do my best, huh? You will win one day. So tomorrow it will be intermediate. It will be still in English and in French. And then right after, on Saturday, it will be advanced. And it's always at the same time. Hopla, it's not here. It's here. It's at 4 Paris time and 10 a.m. New York. Merci beaucoup. Thank you very much. It was really, really, really fun as usual. And well, we'll see when we'll see. Merci encore.
Seist yksin, parvekkeen kaiteella. Alla maailma, jonne et tahdo palata. Suurin ongelma on, ettei ole ongelmaa. Tarpeeksi soha, joka allen sinut musertaa. Sen reunan ja asetut roikkumaani. Et ainoa mitä tehdä pitää, on pitäkin. Hengitä ulos ja hengitä ulos.
reunanía hace tu troiku mani.
Et painomita terapita ompita kiinni.